हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू इंग्लिश क्लास। दिस इज़ योर इंग्लिश मेंटर मीनू पांडे। चिल्ड्रन, आई होप यू हैव लर्नड टू पोएम्स एंड टू स्टोरीज ऑफ द बुक मेरी गोल्ड वेरी वेल। सो नाउ इट्स टाइम टू स्टार्ट ग्रामर। एंड टू स्टार्ट ग्रामर, लेट्स टेक द टॉपिक सेंटेंस एंड इट्स काइंड्स। चिल्ड्रन, वॉट इज अ सेंटेंस? अ ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स which makes a complete sense or gives a complete meaning, that group of words is called a sentence. Let's understand this with example. If I say I pen write, do you understand what I'm trying to convey you? I pen write? No, because it doesn't make any sense. So this is not a sentence. Now when I say I write with a pen, are you getting any meaning? I write with a pen? Yes, of course. So this gives us a complete meaning or makes a sense. So that's why I write with a pen, it is a sentence. Let's take another example. I my father love. Again, no complete meaning, not making any sense. So this is also not a sentence. But when we arrange the words of this group and we get I love my father, I love my father, so this is giving a meaning. So that's why this is a sentence. Now look at this group of words. In the night. In the night. Is it giving you a meaning? Yes, but not complete, not complete sense, not complete meaning. So a group of words which makes a sense but not complete sense, that group of words is called a phrase. Children, what that group of words is called? That group of words is called a phrase which makes a sense but not complete sense. In the night, this is not a complete sentence, but we can use this phrase in making a complete sentence, like I take a glass of milk in the night. Now, what is the difference between a phrase and a sentence? So the basic difference is this: a sentence has a verb. Children, you might have learnt verb in last class. Verb means action words, like take, play, eat, write, read, and many more. So a sentence has a verb, but a phrase does not have a verb. Let's revise the phrase and sentence with some other examples. To the school. Is it a sentence? No, of course not, because again it doesn't give a complete meaning. So to the school, it is a phrase. We are going to school, this is a sentence. Long time ago. You might have read this group of words in many of the stories. Long time ago. So, long time ago, it is a phrase, not a sentence. If we use this in a sentence, we get like this: long time ago, there was a king. Now, what are the characteristics of a sentence? Characteristics means qualities, okay? So, while making sentence, you have to remember a sentence should give a complete meaning. A sentence always begins with a capital letter. Whenever you start writing a sentence, start with a capital letter and ends with a punctuation mark. Punctuation mark like full stop, question mark, or exclamation mark, according to the kinds of sentence. Now, when I talk about kinds of sentence, so let's learn the kinds of sentence. There are four kinds of sentence on the basis of the purpose. Number one, declarative sentence. Children, as you can see, I have put here a full stop. So it shows at the end of declarative sentence, we use a full stop. Number two, interrogative sentence. And at the end of interrogative sentence, question mark is used. So it is very easy to for you to identify interrogative sentence. Imperative sentence is the number third kind of sentence. And at the end of imperative sentence, we again use a full stop. And number four is exclamatory sentence. And you love to enjoy this kind of sentence. And at the end of exclamatory sentence, we always use an exclamation mark. Now let's learn one by one. What is declarative sentence? A sentence which declares something or makes a statement. That kind of sentence is called a declarative sentence. You say many of the statements, many of the things in your daily routine. And as I have already told you, it always ends with a full stop. Let's understand it with some examples. An aeroplane flies in the sky. This is simple statement. An aeroplane flies in the sky. The children are playing football. I want to be a doctor. And many more. So they are the example of declarative sentence. Next is interrogative sentence. A sentence that asks a question is called an interrogative sentence. An interrogative sentence always ends with a question mark. So, is it easy for you to identify? Yes. Now, example, who has broken the vase? Who has broken the vase? So, it means we are asking a question. We are making a query. Why is the child crying? Where is your bicycle? So, these all sentences are interrogative sentences as they make a question. Next category is imperative sentence. A sentence that makes an order or command or a request or wish. That kind of sentence is called an imperative sentence. And at the end of imperative sentence, we use a full stop. Like you might have heard your teacher, your mama, many of the times use this kind of sentences. Bring me a glass of water. Please open the door. Complete your work now. Finish your food. Don't go out to play. So, these kind of order or request are the example of imperative sentence. And children, I just want to add something here. Then here, you word is hidden. Because these all commands or requests are conveying you. Next category is exclamatory sentence. What is exclamatory sentence? A sentence that conveys a feeling or expression, or you can say emotion. That kind of sentence is called an exclamatory sentence. As I have already told you, you love to enjoy because you are full of expression. Na? You say, wow, yippee, ouch, ah. Oh, hey! So, these all expressions show your feeling and emotions. So, they all are exclamatory words. Now, let's have the example of exclamatory sentence. What a beautiful flower! How sad it was! Ouch! I got hurt in my knee. And children, you have to remember, at the end of exclamatory sentence, we use exclamation mark. So again, it is easy for you to identify the kind of exclamatory sentence. Now let's revise all kind of sentence with some more examples. I will read the sentence and you tell me what kind of sentence it is. How far the station is? How far the station is? So it is an exclamatory sentence. Do you know me? I'm making a question. So it is an interrogative sentence. We should respect our elders. Declarative sentence. Stand at ease. This you might have heard during assembly. So this is a command. Stand at ease. So command is an example of imperative sentence. So stand at ease is an imperative sentence. So children, I hope You have learned the sentence and its kind very well. Wash your hands regularly. Be safe, be healthy, and enjoy your lifetime. Bye-bye.